has been quite a wild ride the past year and a half for everyone in this industry, from our destinations to the international tour operators, the press. For us, it's just been a very, very challenging year to try to get IPW to happen again. As we all know, we had to cancel in May of 2020 for obvious reasons, but we really wanted to bring people back to America because what happens at IPW is so important for the international traveler and where they go and how they travel through the USA. In a normal year, IPW would generate $5.5 billion of future travel to the USA. So it was imperative that we get the show back on its feet, but in a safe and healthy way. So what we did is we originally had rebooked for May of 2021, right here in the brand new West Hall of the Convention Center. But then we were looking last fall and things were still looking very, very iffy about getting international delegates to the USA or even being able to meet in a capacity of more than 1,000 or 2,000 folks. So we worked closely with Las Vegas Convention Visitors Authority. It was getting a challenging time though because the second half of their year was already filling up completely in the convention center. All the major resorts exhibit space was filling up from people having postponed over the past year. But they worked really hard because IPW is so important to Las Vegas as well, with international travel just paramount to this city, that they found us this date in September. They kept us in this brand new hall, and we were able to welcome the world in September of 2021. We kept hoping that the borders would move earlier in the year. We had some hope around the G7 conference. There was some hope around 4th of July that the borders would reopen, and it just never happened. So a lot of our exhibitors were getting very nervous that some of their key markets, UK, Ireland, EU, Brazil, India, China, some of the ones that are still impacted by the restrictions in place, that they wouldn't be able to come here. So for some of the exhibitors, they had to weigh, is it worth it for them to participate? But we never gave up on getting the international delegates here. And our government affairs team works so closely with our partners at the national level, with Homeland Security, the State Department, Customs and Border Protection, and was working closely with them to find a way that we can get these really important journalists and buyers to IPW. And there's the national interest exception. Now, a lot of people were aware of this. The typical way is that they would apply through their consulate or the embassy within the market. But with staffing levels so low, those interviews were taking months to plan and just wasn't going to make it feasible. So we spoke again with State Department, CBP, and explained what happens at IPW, that $5.5 billion of future travel to the U.S. is critical and that is in the national interest. So we met that criteria as a show. And then number two, that the people who coming, the journalists and the buyers are essential to be here to make this show happen. So we were granted what was called a 30-day NIE, National Interest Exception, and were able to get 300 delegates approved through that way. This all happened very last minute within the last month, and I would say about 250 of those actually ended up making it. Now, for some, it was challenging. Already logistics were getting difficult. It was so last minute. Certain markets have really reduced airlift, but to get that many here last minute made our exhibitors so happy, made all of us just thrilled to be able to welcome everybody back to the United States. People have not been able to meet in person for over a year and a half. It's been over 2 years since we last had IPW. So we wanted to build in a lot more networking this year. Some people just needed to see each other, to hug or to fist bump, have that cup of coffee, grab a drink in the evening on the show floor, which we've never done before. So just making it a lot more social, letting people catch up. And to that point, sometimes it's those random encounters that end up creating such extraordinary programs or product versus a Zoom call that always has to be so prepared and set up in advance. That kind of happenstance that happens at trade shows was sorely missed the past year and a half. So I'm just seeing people there when they do hug, for those who are comfortable hugging, the hug's a little tighter and a little longer. Seen a few teardrops here and there because this industry, we're family. And people want to do business with those that they really like. A big thank you to our media, our journalists, our buyers, all of our delegates who worked so hard to get to the United States this year. It's been way too long, but we're so glad you make it and welcome, and we can't wait to see you again next year.